Good evening, you're watching The Buck Stops here. I'm Amitabh Ravi.
Good evening, I'm Neha Khanna. Our big focus tonight, it was a moment that left many stunned. The Chief Justice of India breaking down in the presence of the Prime Minister while addressing a conference of Chief Ministers and Chief Justices of the High Courts here in the capital. Justice TS Thakur was choked and seen wiping his tears as he made an emotional appeal to the government saying, save the judiciary.
Well, he urged the Prime Minister to clear the appointment of judges in order to fill the huge number of vacancies and deal with what he called an avalanche of cases pending in the courts. The Chief Justice also told the Prime Minister, you cannot shift the entire burden to the judiciary.
And so we're asking tonight, an overburdened judiciary, mounting pendency of court cases, under trials, languishing in jails, is delivery of justice not a priority for any government?
If nothing else has worked till now, in terms of improving the conditions of the judiciary, an emotional appeal may work.
A rare sight, the Chief Justice of India getting emotional and in tears, appealing to the government to increase the strength of judges, which has been in cold storage for over 3 decades.
We are inviting foreign direct investment into this country. We want people to come and make in India. We want people to come and invest in India.
The Chief Justice did not stop there. He went on to attack Prime Minister Modi's pet project of setting up commercial courts for top corporate clients. Justice Thakur says the system can't work if you're planning to draw from the existing infrastructure.
Simply putting the old wine in the new bottle will not make any difference.
The Prime Minister, who was initially not expected to speak, broke his silence and assured the judiciary that his government was serious in addressing their issues.
मैं सुनकर के चला जाऊंगा ये ऐसा मैं इंसान नहीं हूं मैं उसको सीरियसली लेकर के कुछ रास्ते खोजने के प्रयास करूंगा मैंने एक बार कह दिया था कि साहब कोर्ट का समय बढ़ाएं तो कैसा रहे वैकेशन कम करें तो कैसा रहे उसके बाद लंच था तो लंच में कई जजेज ने मुझे पकड़ा क्या समझते हो अपने आप को
The Chief Justice of India has made a strong case for the appointment and increase of judges. For now, the ball is in the Narendra Modi government's court to find a solution to this problem. With camera person Shalik Ram, Sunil Prabhu, NDTV.
Well, so to talk about this issue, we are now joined tonight by Mr. Soli Sarabji, former Attorney General of India, Justice B.A. Khan, former Chief Justice of the Jammu and Kashmir High Court, also joining us from Jammu. From Mumbai, we're joined by Shaina N.C., BJP spokesperson. And here in the Delhi studio, we have Mr. K.C. Mittal, head of the Congress's legal cell. Shaina N.C., I will come to you first. But before that, I want to quickly draw your attention to a few statistics which are quite staggering. And these have all come from the Chief Justice of India, not from me. An average Indian judge handles 2,600 cases in a year compared to 81 in the US. The lower courts handle 2 crore cases a year. At least 5 crore cases are filed every year and judges dispose of only 2 crore of these. There are 434 judicial vacancies in the high courts. 169 proposals are pending with the government. And as of today, the judge to people ratio stands at 15 judges to 10 lakh people. Shaina, if I could begin with you, the question really is, we saw how the Chief Justice of India broke down in the presence of the Prime Minister, saying save the judiciary. Speeches have been made, but nothing moves, and you cannot shift the entire burden to the judiciary. In a sense, isn't that an indictment of the government coming from the senior most judge in the country? What he is saying is that it just doesn't seem to be a priority for the government.
No, I don't think it's an indictment of the government. If at all, it is a commentary on the current scenario. I was going to narrate the exact statistics that you gave me, so I won't repeat them. But if you take just a simple example of a judge handling 2,600 cases vis-a-vis 81 in the US, it shows you what we need and what is the solution. Since 1987, we have been deliberating, and the Honorable Chief Justice did mention in his speech that we needed then 40,000 judges. And the fact is we have only 21,000 judges. Since then up until now, the population has increased by 25 crores. So we need so many more judges. Now, I think that you need to also give it to our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Modi, because he didn't sit there in denial and say, yes, we'll come up with a solution. He said immediately that we must coordinate, that is, the government and the judiciary, to resolve and come up with a solution. And do realize that this is the same Prime Minister who, in his home state of Gujarat, when he was the Chief Minister, made sure that this backlog of cases which one saw, it was historic, and Mr. Sorabji will second me on this, that how he came up with the solution of holiday courts, judges working overtime, implementation, so that we don't have this kind of a backlog as we do in the center.
Sure.
I do concede that yes, it is a problem that we need to deal with holistically. And when the Honorable Chief Justice got emotional, I'm sure lots of others from the legal fraternity would have also felt the same.
Sure.
But it is imperative to understand that our Prime Minister is a man of conviction, a man of reality who believes in accepting a situation and dealing with
okay.
it holistically.
Okay. So, Shaina, sure, since you mentioned Mr. Sarabji, let me go to Sarabji. Mr. Sarabji, 2.5 crore pending cases. The statistics are there for everyone to know. But considering the dignity of the office of the Chief Justice, could he have brought up the same issue in a different manner?
There's nothing wrong. It wasn't an indictment of anything. He just stated what the situation is and which requires resolution, both in conjunction with the executive and the collegium. Look, just understand one thing. Today, as the law stands, the collegium has the last word in appointing a judge, a person as a judge. Only thing is that the government has information about the activities, the background of the prospective candidate. They may send it to the government, send it to the collegium, and if the collegium reiterates the decision, then the government is bound and this should happen. Now there should not be time taken. Once the collegium reiterates the decision, the government machinery should go in action. And there shouldn't be, to my mind, more than a period of 1 month in making appointments. Why the delay?
Right. Mr. Sarabji, let me take that to Justice Khan. Justice Khan, another argument really that was made by the Chief Justice of India today was that, there's this tug of war constantly going on between the centre and the states and buck passing that we constantly see, as a result of which you have under trials languishing in jails endlessly and there is no justice for the poor. And another staggering statistic that we have here says that according to the National Crime Records Bureau, at the end of 2014, there were almost 3 lakh under trials prisoners in the jails, constituting 2/3 of the total number of inmates. So the question is, just what is the way forward?
Neha, as far as this under trials being in jails is concerned, this is not a problem which is current. This problem we have been facing for years on. So is the problem of delay in dispensing justice, for which there are so many contributory factors, and the foremost being the government's neglect of judiciary and giving it a priority which it deserves. If you look at it for the last so many years, you will find every time we have been holding these debates, every time there have been reports of the Law Commission inviting attention to these problems. Every time Chief Justice's conferences are being held, I have participated in 2, resolutions are being passed, and those resolutions gather dust ultimately in the corridors of the Secretariat, be at the center or in the states. I'll give you 2 examples only to show how judiciary is being treated. In one of the Chief Justice's conference, because of this problem that the matters of judiciary are languishing in the corridors of Secretariat, 2-tier nodal committees were proposed to be set up at the state level, where Chief Justice, Chief Minister, Finance Minister and Law Minister would be one, and then their Chief Secretaries and so on and so forth.
Sure.
That was done to expedite whatever proposals the High Court may make so that those get through the government. But till date, you will find that no state, no high court has implemented that proposal. Mm-hmm. Similarly, we had a proposal that if a government doesn't accept a recommendation made by the high court or, for example, by the Supreme Court for elevation of a judge, and 2 months' time it is not accepted or refused, it will be deemed to have been accepted. It is nowhere followed.
Right.
Now, similarly, so many things, you don't have the right priority for example, in budget. What is the budget of the judiciary they are allotting? Mm-hmm. And what are they doing for the infrastructure? Now, let me tell you the latest, what is this tug of war of the recruitment of judges in the higher judiciary going on. For 3 years, we have been telling the nation that we will give you a transparent and a fair system of recruitment to the higher judiciary.
Sure.
And for that, National Appointments Judicial Commission was conceived. Now, that law was struck down by the Supreme Court, but that is still pending on the issue that a procedure has to be laid down.
Correct.
A memorandum of procedure has to be laid down so that there is a transparency in the system. A criteria is laid down on the basis of which
you're talking about the MOP, the memorandum of procedure.
Mr.
Mittal in now.
They are shuttling this MOP.
Sure. Mr. Mittal, as Saina was pointing out, there is a perception that the BJP government has more of a momentum than, say, when the Congress of the UPA was in power.
No, I don't think this issue is to be seen from that kind of a political angle. And she's not correct. Let me point out, perhaps you missed one thing what the CJI said. He says 169 names have already been lying with the government.
They're still pending,
yes. Yeah, they're pending. Why are they pending? What for? Why should there be a delay on the desk of the government? It should be clear.
Mr. Mittal, you are quoting the Chief Justice of India. I will also quote the Chief Justice of India to you. Another thing that he said today, he actually read out a letter today that was written by his predecessor to Dr. Manmohan Singh when he was the Prime Minister on exactly the same issue. And he says, Dr. Manmohan Singh replied saying it is the states that are not taking the initiative. So how would you respond to that?
Let me point out.
So as it means the, that buck passing has been happening down the years, whether under a Congress government or a BJP government.
It's not a question of buck passing over. The point is, at every stage, as far as appointment of the judges is concerned, it must be expeditiously dealt with.
You were in power for a very long time.
No,
why did the Congress not do it is a question.
No, Congress
that needs
has
to
been
be
doing
asked.
It. Congress has been doing it. You see, 1987, what was the strength of the judiciary? The High Court was 400. From 400, it went to 1056. The appointments were made. After the collegium, the appointments have been withheld.
Sure.
Why should it not be pushed through?
Sure.
Now look at it, Allahabad, 90 vacancies. You see, if you look at in all those orders, the point is, don't look it from that angle. That's why I said it to you. The basic question which we have to address, appointments, number one, the judge's strength, it has to be increased.
Sure.
Of course, it has been periodically increased, but you may require more judges. That's one thing.
Sure.
Number two, there should be no delay in the appointments. Those are the basic two issues on which I think if you do it, then this alone is not a solution to the disposal.
Sure.
There are different other questions also which we may debate.
Let me raise one of those other questions. We're blaming the government. Soli Sarabji, if you look at the Delhi Judicial Service exam in 2014, there were said to be 85 judges who needed to be appointed. 10,000 lawyers and judges gave the preliminary exam, 700 the main exam, and only 15 qualified 2 years later, 1 year later, and all of them were found to have some kind of link to Delhi judges.
So?
The others were also very qualified, 10,000 lawyers and judges who were from the best schools, they'd done very well in their own state exams, and some of them got zero in their essays.
Look, there's one point I want to make.
No.
It's not a question of number of judges.
Mm.
Yeah, number of judges is important. But even if you increase the number of judges, you must see the right kind of judges are appointed. Competent, experienced judges.
Yes.
For example, a revision petition which should take hardly 1 hour for his disposal, at the hands of an experienced, competent judge, takes about 1 day, 2 days before another judge not so experienced. So regard must be held
right
to the person you appoint, not merely the number of persons you appoint.